You know, what kinds of operations do you want to do on binary images? So, you know, often what you want to do is you want to separate objects one from another that are sort of accidentally touching, and you want to collect together pixels that all belong to the same object. And then another thing you might want to do is compute the features of a binary object. And we actually did this also. Remember, we talked about hue moments, and we were talking about moments in general, and moments are a descriptor of the shape of a binary patch. And so, again, those are things that you would do on binary images. So here's an example. This was a thresholded red blood cell image. And by the way, in the old days, not so old. In fact, my mother, I think her first job out of college was as a medical technician. One of the things you had to do was count white blood cells under a microscope, and for a certain amount, and you would count the density. Actually, people sometimes still do that, even today. But what you'd really like to be able to do is spread out a bunch of blood cells and have a machine do the counting. How many red blood cells? How many white blood cells? Especially if instead of just doing a patient at a time, you were doing a massive study and you had tens of thousands of samples you wanted counted, right? So here's an example of taking an image, thresholding it, and you know, if I were to ask you to count how many red blood cells there were, you could probably find all of the, well, let's start with one that's easy, right? You'd say, aha, here's one that's pretty separated, no problem. Here's another one. Oh, but this is a weird one. Look at that. It's got a hole in it. And here are two. Those are probably two, right? But it's one blob connected by a thin thing. So you'd really like to be able to take this image and then fix it up. You know, because in this particular image, there were 63 separate objects detected, and a normal blood cell has an area of about a 50. But you'll notice there are some things here where obviously there were things that were touching each other that were counted as single cells when actually they were gobs. And then there were things that were really small, right? And so here they were just using the number to determine which kinds of things are cells. And what you'd like to do is you'd like to be able to separate out each one of those cells. So we're going to do some binary image operations to do that. And what kind of operations are there? Well, first one we're going to talk just a little bit about is thresholding. Because in some sense, in order to get a binary image, you have to go from a color or grayscale image that has continuous values, or lots of values, to something that just has two, zero and ones. So determining a threshold is always a challenge. Then what you'd like to do is you'd like to find all the pixels that are connected. And that's called connected components analysis. And we'll talk about that. That one's used a lot also to find the independent blobs. And then you want to sometimes improve those blobs, and that's referred to as morphology. And we're going to talk about a variety of morphological operators, including some of the more important ones. Then once you've done all that, then you may compute some features on those blobs, like I was talking about before, moments, areas, these kinds of things.